Nothing left. Christ, life is in a thousand pieces. Million reasons. Why should I keep myself away? Hard to define. It always says it's hard to scream with your throat full of glass. I cannot help it, can't decline. It's always better down the line. I'm in the wrong, and I've done it all before. And I wish I'd never been. And I know it's just a dream. Now I'm blind, I can't open my eyes. Can't stay awake.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Remedy from GSG Gaming Sense Gaming coming to you today with DMC Devil May Cry, the review, or FMC, Fanboys May Cry.
Alright, see you on the other side.
And the first thing I want to discuss is the fact that there's a lot of negativity from fans of the original series. While DMC Devil May Cry, it has no connection to the original series. It does start from the beginning of Dante's exploits as a demon hunter, and it shows its growth into a similar counterpart of the classic Dante. All the major characters from the original are in DMC, but Ninja 3 has revised the tale and puts more of a contemporary spin on it. The story takes place in Limbo City, a town secretly controlled from the shadows by powerful demons that manipulate humanity. Living in this brainwashed society is Dante, a punk-ass youth at odds with demons who constantly hunt him. Over the course of his battles, Dante is contacted by the Order, a rogue group led by his long-lost brother Virgil. He's hell-bent on exposing the demons to the world and releasing Limbo City from their clutches. Order's reasons for recruiting Dante is because he alone possesses a particular gene that can be used to combat the demons. While Dante fights alongside the Order, he will learn of his past and the family he never knew, while coming to grips with the incredible powers that come with being a son of Sparta. Not Sparta. Sparta. The combat in this game is definitely the focal point. Plain and simple, if you can't combo, you're gonna die. You require many different weapons to choose from and link together. Chaining combos can be difficult without practice, but whooping some ass feels really good. Watching gameplays of Triple S combos is probably gonna be very entertaining. In short, the combat can be summed up in two words: artful violence. The game is fairly short, but it does offer a lot of replay value. There are 7 different difficulties, as well as a ton of collectibles to get in-game, and there are some secret levels as well. And FYI, I would finish your first playthrough before trying to go for the collectibles. You can't collect them all on your first playthrough, so just enjoy the story mode. The storyline was great, start to finish. I loved all of the music in the game. The soundtrack was awesome. The graphics are great, I like the art style a lot, and the combat was a little frustrating at times, but overall addicting, and once you actually start improving on your combos, it feels a lot better, and you actually start to enjoy it. Nothing stands out as a game breaker in this game, but I do have one gripe, and that's the fact that there's a lack of a lock-on feature, and every once in a while the camera can be thrown into some awkward angles. So the only question remaining is, should you rent it, buy it, or avoid this game altogether? I definitely would recommend renting it. It's only got about 10 plus hours of gameplay. If you are feeling like a tryhard, you're going to want to buy this. You won't be finishing every difficulty in a few days. And that's it for my review. Go ahead and voice your opinion down in the comment section below. This is Remedy. I'm out.
But
you can call me Dante the Demon Killer. Has a nice ring to it, don't you think?
You want to kill me? You can't kill me! I'm 1,200 years old!
You don't look a day over 12,000.
Fuck you!
Fuck you!
Fuck you!